Welcome to my presentation about adaptive GUI design tailored to user groups for public health and spatial decision support.
My name is Melanie Platz and I am a PhD student and research assistant at the University of Koblenz-Landau at the Institute of Mathematics. I am working on the usage of mathematical modeling for the mathematical optimization of spatial public health, including the use of adaptive GUI design for digital devices tailored to different user groups for early warning and decision support. First, I will give an overview. Then, I will say something about application of adaptive GUI design tailored to user groups for digital devices. And finally, I will give a conclusion and an outlook. Overview. On this sheet, you can see the example of an early warning and response cycle. Subject of this cycle is a viral disease transmitted by mosquitoes, for example chikungunya. The cycle starts at the lower left with collecting data, then it goes to the upper left where early warning is generated, then to the upper right where response support is delivered, and then to the lower right where the distribution of resources is done. Finally, you are at the starting point of the cycle and it starts again with collecting ground data. On this sheet, you can see the places in the cycle where my research is incorporated. Between diagnosis support and response support, risk maps are generated. This is done for the visualization of risk. For the response support, resource maps are generated and a graphical user interface for governmental facilities is developed. Finally, a graphical user interface for Joe Public, who might be located in a hazardous area, is developed as well. The mainly used mathematical tools in this context are fuzzy logic and measure theory. Some additional information about the project Reclam Health and Logistics and the significance of open source software can be found by following the links listed on this sheet. Application of adaptive GUI design tailored to user groups for digital devices. On this sheet you can see a risk map about the mosquito survival of Anopheles mosquitoes depending on rainfall and humidity. Red denotes high risk and green denotes low risk. For developing a malaria risk map, more parameters have to be included. A project with a 12th grade intensive mathematics course was performed. The task was to determine the quality of locations of Africa for building wells. Several risk and response maps were used. Combination of those maps was done with fuzzy logic and convex combination. Two maps that were used in this project are shown on this sheet. On the left, the groundwater storage of Africa, and on the right, the average annual water use in Africa. This is the result of the project. This map shows the quality of locations for building wells based on groundwater storage, estimated depth to groundwater, aquifer productivity, infrastructure, and water needs for all sectors, where green denotes good location for building wells and red denotes bad location for building wells. This map can be used for decision support. When generating risk maps, we have to consider the following. Risk is the product of probability and impact. The impact differs for different user groups. Joe Public wants to know, am I located in an hazardous area? How can I get out of this hazardous area? And what preventive measures can be done? A governmental facility wants to know where and how to intervene, who must be warned, where to allocate which resources, and which advice and decision support can be delivered to the population. On this sheet you can see Joe Public, who is located in an hazardous area for example, malaria. The next sheet describes what Joe Public sees on the display of the mobile device.
This is an example for a graphical user interface for Joe Public. The user interface uses augmented reality. The background is colored red. This means Joe Public is located in an hazardous area. The scale on the upper right shows the same. Below, you can see how reliable the displayed information is. The spatial quality of information is important because risk maps are always interpolated, because you cannot measure risk on each point, and the quality of the measurements may vary as well. On the lower right, you can see what preventive measures can be done by JoePublic. On the lower left, you can find a help button. On the upper left, you can see an arrow pointing into the direction to go to get out of the hazardous area as fast as possible. At the moment, pedestrian mode is set.
On this sheet, the graphical user interface for JoePublic is further described. On the upper right, the risk map is linked. On the lower right, the fastest way to the next doors where you can buy mosquito nets and insect repellents can be displayed. An arrow guides you. On the upper left, you can see what happens when you choose another mode than pedestrian mode. You can choose, for example, car mode or train mode, then you will be guided to the next train station, or plane mode, then you will be guided to the next airport.
On this sheet, measures for the optimization of the graphical user interface are listed. They were proposed by some mathematical gifted students within a project where path problems had to be solved. See the link below. Afterwards, they concerned with graphical user interfaces. The proposals for the optimization are the following. An energy-saving version should be developed because not everywhere energy is available. An offline version should be developed because internet is not available everywhere as well. Another idea was to measure the walking speed of the user to indicate whether the measured walking speed is maintained. A disabled version should be developed, for example, a wheelchair-friendly version, or version for colorblind or blind users. And priorities should be selectable by the user. Imagine the following situation. You are not located in an hazardous area, but a person you want to save is located in an hazardous area. To save this person, you have to path through the hazardous area. The graphical user interface should guide you to the person that has to be saved, and then out of the hazardous area on the best way. That means on the way where you are exposed to the lowest possible risk.
This is an example for how to make the priorities selectable by the user. The green point shows where you are located now, and you can click on the display where you want to go. This is the red point. The arrow guides you into the right direction. On this sheet, you can see a graphical user interface for a governmental facility to determine where to build wells. On the lower right, you can choose how many wells you want to build. Then the best locations will be displayed, visualized by blue points. Adaptive graphical user interface design is working as follows. It is based on collected information about the user. The digital device is delivering information about the location of the user by GPS or IP and about the previous user settings. The user is delivering information by his action, his reaction on the decision support, and his answers on certain questions. Afterwards, information about how to adapt the graphical user interface in an optimal way to the user is delivered to the digital device. Conclusion and outlook.
Aim is the development of an executable prototype. Therefore, adaptive graphical user interfaces tailored to different user groups that support the understanding of the spatial sense have to be generated. Exclusively open source software should be used. The application should be available offline, and the processes have to be automized. The accomplished milestones are listed on this sheet. Graphical user interfaces tailored to the user groups JoePublic and governmental facilities were designed, but have to be evaluated and optimized. An algorithm for adaptive user design is in labor and has to be implemented in the future. Exclusively open source software was used.
Finally, I will give an outlook. Certain graphical user interface elements will be evaluated within an empirical study with regard to the determination of an initial graphical user interface design, adaptivity, comprehensibility, benefit for the user, and conceiving the spatial sense. and a prototype will be generated by automating processes and implementing algorithms. Thank you for your attention.